Hello students, so in this video you are going to learn about the problems on DC circuits. Coming to the first problem, so here we have a problem, a circuit consisting of two parallel resistors having a resistance of 20 ohm and 30 ohm respectively, connected in series with a 15 ohm resistor, if the current through 15 ohm resistor is 3 amperes, find the current in 20 ohm and 30 ohm resistors, and second one is voltage across the whole circuit and the total power consumed in the all the resistors. So total power in the consumed in the all the resistors we have to find out. Circuit will not be given for this problem. We have to draw the circuit according to the statement. So here 15 ohm resistor is 20 ohm and 30 ohm resistors are connected in parallel with the with the 15 ohm resistor. So like that is given. So circuit you have to draw, and 3 amperes current is flowing in 15 ohm resistor. So what we have to find out, current is 20 ohm and 30 ohm. So use current division principle. Current flowing in the one resistor is equal to total current into opposite resistor value divided total resistance. I1 is equal to 3 into 30 divided by 20 plus 30. So you will get 1.8 amperes. According to current division principle you have to calculate. And current flowing in 30 ohm is equal to 3 into 20 ohm, opposite resistor is 20 ohm divided by 20 plus 30, so you will get 1.2. so if we add these two values, that should be equal to total current. So 1.8 plus 1.2 is equal to 3. So then your values are correct. Then coming to this voltage drop across the whole circuit, so find the total equivalent resistance, 20 these two equivalent resistance, and find out. So here equivalent resistance, otherwise you can calculate V is equal to I1 into 20 plus I into 15. This is our another method. So you can do it, equivalent resistance, add equivalent resistance and total current. If you multiply, you will get 81 volts. So that is second one. And total power, power across 20 ohm, power across 30 ohm, power across 15 ohm. So here power across the 20 ohm is equal to, so I square R formula, P is equal to, we have a I square R formula. We have power, to find the power we have different formula, three different formulas we have. So you know, here we know the current flowing in the resistor and resistor value, then you can find out the power using I square R formula. So 1.8 volt square into 20 is equal to 64.8 watts. Similarly, 30 ohm resistor power is equal to 1.2 volt square into 30, so 43.2 watts. And similar 15 ohm resistor power is equal to 3 square into 15, that is equal to 135 watts. So this is about this problem. So here we have calculated current in the 20 ohm, 30 ohm by using current division principle, voltage up across the whole the circuit, so 81 volts, and total power consumed is like I square R formula, P is equal to I square R formula we have used and we have calculated. Okay, and next one is one more problem. An 8 ohm resistor is in series with a parallel combination of two resistors, 12 ohm and 6 ohm. So 12 ohm and 6 ohm, if the current in 6 ohm is 5 amperes, determine the total power dissipated in the circuit. So here 6 ohm current is given, 6 into 30, so 30 divided by 12, if you put you will get the current flowing in the I2 resistor, 12.5, 5 plus 2 is equal to 5 plus 2.5 is equal to 7.5 amperes current flowing in the 8 ohm resistor. So here you can calculate either using the P is equal to VI or P is equal to I square R, otherwise calculate the total total resistance of the circuit and find out the power. So here what we did, so here current flowing in 6 voltage across the 6 ohm resistor is 6 into 5 into 6, that is 30 watts, so 30 volts, and 12 current flowing in 12 ohm resistor is 30 by 12, so 2.5 amperes, so 7.5 amperes, total current is 7.5 amperes. And total resistance of the circuit RAB is equal to 8 plus 12 parallel to 6. So this one is 12 ohms, right? then total power P is equal to I square R AB. So total 7.5 into 12, so 675 watts you will get. So this is also one of important problem. This problem asked in external examination one or two times they asked in examination. So practice this problem well. And we'll move to the another problem. So this is also important problem. So we have to find out the voltage or obtain the potential difference between V x y. X y points voltage we have to find out. So here here. So x and y we have to find out. X and y these points. These points. What is the voltage drop? V x y. So here first you find out the loop loops. So here you can take this is one loop. So this is the loop one. And this is loop 2. So loop current is I1 you consider, and loop 2 current is I2 you consider. Apply KVL. So I1 is equal to 2 divided by 2 plus 3 0.4 amperes will get. I3 is equal to 4 by 5 plus 3 0.5 amperes will get. Now voltage drops you find out across 3 ohm, across this loop 1 3 ohm resistor, loop 2 3 ohm resistor. See here 3 into here, how we have to draw here x and so this is the x point, y point, here 3 ohm, also here also 3 ohm. The current flowing in the resistor is 0.4 into 4 into 3, so 1.2. See here 0.5 into 3, 1.5 also. So now plus here plus minus minus plus. So here plus minus. Here 1.5 will be plus. So this is plus minus 4 minus 3. So here what we will get? So here 3 into I2 minus 4 minus 3 into I1. So according to the direction of the path, so direction of the path if you take, so you will get minus 3.7 volts. Here the voltage Vxy is the voltage of point x with respect to point y. To find this voltage we start from y and traverse the path x to the x. So find the total voltage rise is minus 3.7 volts. So like this you can find out. So otherwise x to y also you can find out, y to x also you can find out. So answer will get same answer, minus 3.7 volts. So this problem is very very important. Maybe this time they may ask for your examination. So problems practice the problems well, and also some more problems are there in Google Classroom material, and also I have solved problems on problems in class. So many problems I have solved. Practice all problems and practice also from textbook. So if you have any doubt and you can ask me. In next video we will discuss about AC fundamentals introduction. So in AC fundamentals, what is the AC circuit, what is the DC circuit, and how instantaneous value will be calculated, how cycle frequency, time period, those definitions we will discuss in next video. Okay, thank you everyone.